Hello. As part of the Night King Invasions event, we had another event like the Dears event, the Maiden Relics, called this time as Citadel Bounty. In this event, you have to collect bounty orders in order to buy rewards from the shop. We can see the shop right here. It has a lot of good things and it has the same appearance as the Dear events. However, it is confirmed that there is no relationship between this event and Maiden Relics, even though they look so similar. The bounty orders are going to be used only for the current event. It is related exclusively to the event of the Night King Invasion, so it probably will not come back in the future. You have to spend all your bounty orders in this event. The Maiden Relics will come back in the future. It's not cancelled or replaced by this event, it's just a different thing. So, focusing on that, you can get the bounty orders via several ways. Every day you have to kill rebel camps, rebel groups, some white walkers, and you can also get the bounty orders via packs. You can find bounty orders in every pack that appears in the shop. So everything that you will buy from the Black Diamond store during this event will give you some bounty orders and will help you buy more rewards from that event. There is also a specific pack for that event, the Citadel Bounty, that gives a highest amount of bounty orders. The first pack costs 10 Black Diamonds and gives 35 bounty orders. The second pack costs 50 Black Diamonds and gives 100 bounty orders. The third pack costs 200 Black Diamonds and gives 360 bounty orders. The fourth pack costs 500 Black Diamonds with 900 bounty orders. And the last one costs 1000 Black Diamonds and gives 1800 bounty orders. These are the base values of the Black Diamonds needed. You can also apply some coupons on these packs, like the Honor Token coupons. The analogy of Black Diamonds and bounty orders for the last three packs is 1.8 bounty orders for each Black Diamond, while in the previous packs it's 3.5 for the first and 2 bounty orders for one Black Diamond in the second pack. However, the last three packs also give some epic tokens besides the diamonds and the speedups. Let's now focus on the shop of this event and the things that we can redeem. We have the Miracle of Flames permanent voucher that costs 4000 bounty orders, and along with the two other permanent castle exteriors, they are the most expensive things in the shop. Personally, I don't like any of these castle exteriors, and considering the value that they have, I would not recommend to focus on that. We also have two marching animations that can be quite useful depending on your fighting style. Besides that, we have troop skins, refinement stones, dragon experience and dragon marks. We have commander medals, equipment selection chests, honor banners, some gold, some speedups, and transnational relocation scrolls. All the things in this shop are quite good, and considering the amount that you can buy, it's pretty decent. What you should buy depends on your priorities. I am not a fan of buying dragon marks or refinement stones, although the value is pretty good, especially for the green refinement stones. I am not a fan because, for example, I will have max refinement in 2 months and I will regret it that I bought the refinement stones just to have the max refinement 2 days before that. So I think it's better to focus on other things. As I said, the castle exteriors I am not a fan of, while the marching animations are quite good only if you play a specific style, as there are not similar, a bit worse marching animations in a recruitment pass like for the castle skins. In my personal opinion, the universal troop medals are the best depending on your account. For medium spenders that don't have S or A Universal Troop skins maxed, it can be quite good in order to advance there, especially A Universal Troop medals that are cheaper, but they are a lot more difficult to find in packs or in other events as rewards. About the SS Universal Troop medals, I think that the amount that you can get is quite small. For example, with the bounty orders I have now, I can get 14 SS medals. Considering that there are several ways that currently we can get SS medals, even if they are small amounts, like on Treasure Seeker, I think that it doesn't worth to overlook the other things in the shop for SS medals. The S and A medals I think are better for medium spenders, or if you are rushing in order to get a Commander Gold, some Commander medals can be good, although the price is quite big. For example, with the best analogy, you can get one Commander medal for 10 Black Diamonds, which is a lot higher than in the Black Diamond shop. However, this may be the only way for a free-to-play player in order to unlock some commanders, as not every commander here is given free-to-play on other events. So in that case, it can be worth it. I find very attractive the equipment selection chests. With these chests, you can select which equipment chest you want to convert them. Based on the amount of chests that you can get via this event, I think if you don't have max gear and if you are trying to advance with the Kingsguard set that requires to advance several other equipment sets, I think it really worth it. For example, with my current bounty orders, with which I can buy only 14 SS medals, I can buy 214 times the equipment chests, which gives two chests, so I can buy more than 400 equipment chests, and this can give really a boost. Although the drops are quite crap, 400 chests can give really good items. Certainly ignore the speed ups and the gold, and remember to buy them before Saturday night reset, because otherwise you will lose the rewards. You have to spend every single bounty order you have. Thank you a lot for watching.